Welcome to Dharma Research Pakistan. We are in Pushkalawati, the holy city of Gandhara. It was a capital of Gandhara before the Peshawar became the capital in the times of the King Kanishka. So it is older than King Kanishka and the Peshawar itself. You can see this is a mountain, but this is not a mountain, this is a mound. And this is the place where the temple of Hariti was located. And it's a legend, it's a Buddhist legend that the Buddha converted the Hariti to Buddhism. We are on the top of this mound. Here it is a place where the temple of Hariti was situated. She was known as the mother of the demons, simply known as Hariti. This is northern India, and this temples are found in central India, and even today in Nepal, the Hariti is worshipped, and it is recorded in the 7th century and in the 5th centuries when Fa Xian and Huanzang from China visited this area, and they recorded it in their memoirs. They wrote details about this site and about the legend associated with this site. And Hariti, she had not no less than 500 children, and she used to devour, she used to eat the children of the surrounding. And the Buddha in his previous birth once took away her favorite son, and by the laws of her favorite son, she was wandering, she was very upset, and she went to Buddha. And Buddha said that if one of your son is lost, you are so upset, you are wandering here and there, so if you are eating the children of other, then how would they feel? So this was the time when Buddha converted him, and she fell, and she converted to Buddhism, and from that point onward she became the healer of the children. She became the symbol of the safety of children, and the temple was erected here, and it has been more than 2000 years since this the healing power, the temple was later on, there was no temple, there was nothing, but only the moons, and the moons were capable of healing the children of the surroundings, the people, the women, the mothers, the anxious mothers, and this is especially the red face, the measles, the smallpox, the treatment of these kinds of diseases which were found in children's. And this is the place where the healing power is bestowed upon the Hariti. This place is sacred, this place is spiritual, and this place has got the immense power to heal children. It has been 2000 years since this Indian Buddhist legend Hariti, and with the passage of time, the time has changed, the buildings have collapsed, and the legends disappeared with the passage of time. And in the 10th and 11th century, the name of Gandhara disappeared. The Buddhist people or the ancient people who were living here, they disappeared from the scene. But the one important thing, the tradition, the culture, and the healing powers which were bestowed upon this temple of Hariti, and this place did not disappear with the passage of time. And even today, here is a shrine which local name is Bibi Sayyida, the unique kind of shrine, because it is been it is on the name of a female saint. Majority or most of this Muslims shrines, they are male, but here this is a female saint whose name, whose shrine is here, and The tradition is, the culture is, even today, the anxious women are bringing their children to this Muslim shrine, and they, with smallpox, with measles, and any other diseases which are inflicted to the children. So they are being healed here. Even today, the monastery is over, the stupa is over, the people are over, the name Gandhara is over, but the healing power, they are still here. So it is in the nature, it is in the soil, and it is in the air, this spirituality and this healing power, which by any means, no one could have taken it away from this soil. And today it has been practiced, and the legend of Hariti is still alive in the local population, and it will be alive in the coming years. This is a shrine of Bibi Sayyida, which is located in the area where the temple of Hariti was situated. Here, a lot of people, a lot of mothers are coming with their children, but unfortunately, due to cultural restraints, we cannot show you the footage of those anxious mothers who are coming. But the 1 hour that we spend here, we have seen hundreds of women here that they are visiting this, and every day it's been, you know, and it's a full-fledged legend that is continued and that is popular in the whole province, and people from far off places, they from nearby villages and from other cities.
We visited the shrine of Bibi Sayyida. We brought a child who is infected by measles. Because visit of this shrine is treatment for all diseases of newborn babies. One of our child was unstable emotionally. We brought him here because it is the place of his treatment. They gave us amulets and some holy scripture. It is very old shrine. Once we brought our nephew here and he recovered. Then we brought another child, he also recovered. A lot of people are visiting this shrine. It is respected by the people.
We are in Pushkalavati, and this is the shrine of Bibi Sayyida, which is exactly on the place where the temple of Hariti was situated. And from that time, people used to bring, or the anxious mother used to bring their children with diseases like smallpox and measles. So we will talk with the caretaker of this shrine.
Dalta sumra wada razi. Taka mashuman rozana razi lakas.
Rozana da khabar da chi da juma aw itwar. De bande lko dir zeta razi kana.
Haji.
Pa as yuras bande ya dir ya lko dumra smara mung tanu malumigi.
These are the amulets, which is known as taviz in the local language. These are being given to the newborn babies. It's also been given to the newborn babies, and this is called Sakht in the local language. So these are practiced in central India, in Nepal, and in Kashmir also.
From miles around, when a child is attacked by red face, which means smallpox and measles, the parents are certain to bring it here in the mouth of the little patient, and in its taviz, the amulet holder, which hangs from its neck and which is of the same pattern as those of the Grisho Buddhist statues, is put a pinch of earth from the top of the moon, and immediately it is cured. Why? Because it is so, the present inhabitants are incapable of giving the slightest semblance of a reason for this belief. Though the rite has been preserved, the legend has perished, and they have not taken the trouble to invent another. It is not, as far as they know, by virtue of any peer or Musliman saint. There is no ziyarat here. Moreover, the place is as good for Hindu as for Pathan children. The mothers of both come here bringing as offering grains of rice and wheat. In short, we establish here a case as rare in Gandhara as it is common in Kashmir, where an old custom, originally Indian, has continued to be practiced by Muslims until the present day. Perhaps here some particular reasons, such as the practical utility of the rite, the general belief of the Afghans in the healing powers of the holy places, and the want of orthodoxy of anxious mothers may serve to explain a survival so entirely exceptional in this country.
In the 5th century AD, in the 7th century AD, the Fazian and Huansang visited this place, and in those times it was a thriving city, a thriving temple, but now it has been converted into ruins, into mounds, and the British archaeologists in the 1920s and 30s, they worked here, they surveyed here, and they follow the track or the route of the Fazian and the Huansang. But and still, if you want to find out about this place, you will find the records of the British archaeologist, which they worked here and they surveyed these places and they write the records. And according to them, it is exactly the place where the temple of Hariti was situated. But after the partition of India, it's been 70 or 75 years that nobody has worked here, and nobody has paid attention to this place. And even this is the land of the local people, which according to their will, they can level it, they can dig it, and they have, if you see, constructed houses above this mound. So this is the culture, this is the heritage of Gandhara, this is the heritage of Buddhist roots. So it needs to be protected, it needs to be preserved, and it needs to be promoted, because these are the roots of Buddhism, the roots of humanity, the roots of our history, and the roots of our culture. So a barbed wire is required to protect it. This land, the government of Pakistan needs to acquire this land from local people, and they need to fix a few signboards here which can give a clue of the past glory, and they should conduct research, and they need to publish a few pamphlets and few small books about which the history of this place has been written. And above all, this place needs excavation, which will reveal the history, which might reveal the British archaeologist has excavated this place. They found many sculptures, many Kharoshti script scripture, and images of the mother of the demons, or simply you can say the images of Hariti. And still this place is full of the evidence, of a historical evidence. So if the government of Pakistan pay attention to it, so it will have been a great help to protect and preserve our history. This is yes, Buddhist history, but this is the history of Pakistan.